So far, you've derived two potential schemes for a distributed bitonic merge. The first is a block distribution scheme. Remember that it has log p stages of communication followed by log n over p stages of purely local computation. The second scheme was the cyclic scheme. It has log n over p stages of purely local computation followed by log p stages of communication. Now, the running time for the two schemes is the same. It's basically alpha log p plus beta times n over p log p. Now, looking at these terms, you might worry about the beta term. If n over p is really large and the beta term dominates the alpha term, then it looks like you're paying to send n over p words log p times. So, a natural question is there an alternative that would let you reduce the cost of the beta term, possibly at the cost of increasing the alpha term? In fact, there is. First, let's start cyclic. Starting cyclic means there's no communication initially. Then, let's switch to block. Switching to block means at the end, there's no communication. Of course, to make this scheme work, you're going to need to reshuffle the data in between. This reshuffling is called a transpose. You can view the transpose as either a matrix transpose or also as an all-to-all personalized exchange. Let's take the first process, for instance. Notice that it has to send p minus 1 messages, each of size n over p squared. Notice that it has to send these messages to each of the other processes. The same thing goes for every other process. For example, let's look at the last process. So, how does this scheme compare to the block or cyclic schemes? Again, let's recall the block and cyclic communication times, assuming a hypercube. Now, since the transpose needs to do an all-to-all, let's make a stronger assumption, which is that the network is fully connected. In that case, computing the cost would be really easy. So if the network is fully connected, then each process will send p minus 1 messages, and the messages will be of size n over p squared. So as you can see, each scheme exhibits a latency bandwidth trade-off relative to the other. So here, we get rid of the log p factor on the beta term at the cost of increasing the alpha term factor from log p to p. Now in practice, it's typically very hard for the block or cyclic schemes to actually beat the transpose schemes for typical values of n over p. And that's true even given the much stronger assumption of a fully connected network versus a hypercube. Can you think of any reasons why that might be true?